All right, what is going on, guys? Today, we got a leg day. I think I'm gonna do an overall complete leg day today. I was supposed to kind of do more hamstrings today, but my forearms and biceps are killing me, so I'm not gonna do any like super heavy deadlifts, which is what I would normally do. So, start with some squats. This is something I could do like almost every single leg day if I really had to. I like to switch it up, but it's definitely something I could do if I needed to. Let's get rolling right into this. We got 315 on the bar. Last time I did sets of 8, so I think today we're gonna go for sets of 10. Pretty good set. Last night I went in and I was looking at some of my analytics. My watch time retention is like horrible. I'm posting these 18, 20 minute long videos and they're getting like not a whole lot of retention. You know what I mean? So people click on them. You know, my views are going up, but there's not a lot where I like stick through the end of the video, which I get it. You know what I mean? I'm like a smaller creator. People are probably just like clicking through it and, you know, seeing whatever's up. I kind of completely forgot that you could look at stuff like that, and that was like, I felt like a punch to the gut. Like, I've just been making all this long form content. And like I said, I've been seeing the views kind of going up a little bit, but the retention isn't there, which is, it just sucks, you know? There's a lot of things I could say that, you know, to describe it, but it is what it is, you know? I've definitely tried like multiple styles of content too, and unfortunately this is like my favorite style of like I said, just plopping my camera down and just talking to you guys and sharing my lifting journey, you know, because everybody's is a little bit different and everybody goes through different things and different struggles, different challenges, different goals, you know, everything. You know, so this is like the easiest way for me to share it. I don't have like any crazy editing, fancy this or that, you know, so I wish I had a little bit more attention, but it is what it is. I'm still gonna post and hopefully, you know, it picks up over time. This is gonna be my last set of this. My squat's not feeling like great right now, so I don't wanna like push it any more than I need to. One of the worst things about squatting and trying to film it is I have to like back up really far. And if you've ever squatted and you squat with heavy weight, like you really only take like 2 steps back just to clear the rack. So it's kind of like a major pain in the ass. So yeah, let's just get this. You know, for most people, at least in the bodybuilding realm, whenever they're working out, they typically stick to one muscle group for the majority of their workout, you know, with synergist muscles helping and stuff like that. For example, like if you're doing chest, you're gonna be working your triceps. So if you start off with a chest exercise and you go into a tricep exercise, you don't really need to re-warm up your triceps because they've already been working. But with legs, in my opinion, if you're doing a movement like a squat, just primarily focus on your quads, you know, your hamstrings maybe help out just a little bit. Nothing too crazy. As soon as you go into a hamstring movement, which is what I'm about to do, I'm about to do some RDLs, I'm gonna re-warm up my hamstrings. I'm not just gonna go into the heaviest set possible of what I do with RDLs because they haven't been properly warmed up. You know, in my opinion, with legs, your synergist muscles, sometimes depending on what your workout structure is and what you are doing for the day, you may have to warm up that muscle group before you go ahead and start actually hitting that muscle, you know? So I'm gonna warm up, do some lighter RDLs before we go into my top set. So yeah, just a little tip for you guys. All right, let's move into our first working set. feel like I can't be the only person that thinks this, but whenever I put my feet down, and even if I'm directly under the bar, I feel like I can never get my feet straight. You know what I mean? Like sometimes I feel like even right now, I feel like this should be a little bit more forward, and now it feels even, you know? I feel like unless I have a mark on the ground, it's really hard for me to actually realize if my feet are even, because I can just like step forward like this. My feet are relatively even, but you know, this foot's out a little bit more than this one. So now I have to kind of, you know, and even, I feel like even when I consciously think about it, I still fuck it up. I don't know. Let's just hit this fucking set. How convenient that seat was just right behind me. I think the perfect comparison to like the sound of a perfect swish in bodybuilding is when you pop the lever on your belt after a lift. It just sounds so satisfying. It's the same thing if you perfectly barrel a ball in baseball. You know, just like that crisp, nice sound. I guess maybe the only other thing is if you push two metal plates together and you just hear that clank. Maybe that's a little bit better. I don't know, you guys comment what you think. What's that equivalent sound to like that perfect, just like satisfying sound and lifting? One thing that you don't realize when you start content creation is how much you fucking stutter, man. At least for myself, like I'll say something and then think about it and be like, oh, I probably should say that a different way. So for everybody that like live streams, and I'm gonna eventually start doing it too, but like you literally can't cut anything out. So you gotta make sure, like, not that I'm worried about whatever the fuck I'm gonna say, like I'm gonna say what I want, but sometimes I feel like I have to reword things like 3-4 times. I'm like, I didn't say that quite right. But that does not happen when you're live. Everything goes. All right, let's get this. Almost there. That, you know, one thing I think I'm pretty good at is I come to the gym even when I feel like shit. And I don't mean like mentally feel like shit. Like, I feel like I'm a fucking yak right now. And it probably doesn't help that I'm wearing a belt and I'm like pushing into it. But holy fuck. Bro, I could be on my deathbed. I'm coming to the gym. I don't give a flying fuck. I will be here. I got a headache. I feel like I'm gonna vomit. I might shit my pants on this next set. I don't give a fuck. We're here. We're moving on to the leg press. I don't know why, but I feel like I can't really go heavy on leg press, man. This is a machine I haven't really used that much, and I only started using it within like the past year. When I first started lifting, I learned on barbells, so I learned how to do everything with a bar. So that was like what I was really comfortable with. I've been coming to the gym for a while, but using machines, and especially the leg press, is something that I'm not as familiar with. I haven't really used the leg press all that much in my life, and I don't know, it just, whenever I go heavy, like it just feels weird in my joints, and I don't know, going heavy with squats is like not that big of a deal for me, but this just never feels good. So I'm just gonna go 4 plates on each side. And yeah, let's just get into this. We're gonna hit 3 sets of this. Hey. Hey. I think with each muscle group, there's gonna be some exercises that you may not like, but if you can find a variation to do them, you should try to do it that way. You know, like some people may not like leg press, so you can squat if you don't like to back squat. You can do Smith squats. If you don't like Smith squat, you can do the hack squat machine. You know, so I think they're all very similar movements, and so I've always just gravitated away from the leg press. But as long as you do, say, one or two of them, you know, for the most part, you're gonna see leg growth overall, and in that case, for any muscle group, you'll see growth as long as you are doing one of the variations, you know? Last set of this one. You know, I want to get this quad portion of this workout finished because that's kind of what's killing me right now. The squats and the leg press. I'm gonna finish with this leg extension. We got three sets of this. Just a couple more things and then this workout is over. I keep saying it, but I gotta start running, man. I gotta start. Last set, let's get it. All right, we're moving on to this seated leg curl. Almost done for the day. Workout's almost finished. This shit will pump up your hamstrings real quick. Hey. Hey. You know, a real key to growing your legs is growing your hamstrings, man. A lot of people, you see their quads, and obviously that's a big dominant part of your leg, but if you can get this shit hanging down here, you're good. Don't worry about it, no worries. See, that's what I'm talking about. People at my gym are so nice, and they like apologize for walking through my camera, and I don't give a fuck. That's like the second time it's happened today where somebody was like, oh, I'm sorry. It's a nice gesture, but I do not care. Anyways, look at my fucking hamstring. All this shit, all this, man, I mean. It adds a lot of thickness to your legs, more than you would think. You know, like I said, the quad's very dominant, but if you can grow your hamstring, man, that'll really, really blow up your legs. A lot of leg curls like this and a lot of deadlift, that will help blow up your fucking hamstrings. Hey. Need to drop the weight. All right, this is the last thing for the day. This is the best angle I can get. There's not, I'm sure you can see there's like three machines around me. So we're finishing with this calf raise. Nothing too crazy, just all the way up. and all the way down, really making sure to control this. But yeah, today was a pretty full leg day, nothing. Pretty much did everything, quads, hamstrings, a little bit of glutes, and now we're finishing with some calves. Well, seeing as it doesn't seem like a lot of people watch through the entirety of the video, if you did somehow watch through the entirety of the video, leave a comment. I'd really appreciate that. Leave a like. Appreciate all your guys' support. But yeah, let's just finish this last set here and get out of here. Always make sure to re-rack your weights. Even if it's not a whole lot, make sure to do it. All right, well that's it for today's video. If you guys enjoyed that video, make sure to leave a like, subscribe, check out my YouTube, Instagram, @BeamGetsBuff. And yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video.